Hi, Eddie. Good to see Jack Willis getting his first start. Can you tell us why he made it this week and what you hope to see from him in this match?
Well, selection's a constant action plan. We're always looking to see how we can keep improving the side, keep improving the depth. Sometimes it's about improving the performance of a position. Sometimes it's about improving the depth of the position. And with Jack Willis, we've got an opportunity to increase the depth at seven. So we wanted to see how he performs at the test level. He's come into camp since the Premiership final and trained very well. He's got a great attitude and we feel he deserves the opportunity. And we've rested Sam Underhill for this week, but he'll obviously come into contention further down the track.
His statistics this year on turnovers are incredible. What do you think makes him so special about that? Is it a physical thing or is it partly his anticipation and judgment?
Well, club rugby is one thing and then it comes down to test rugby. But I think he's got a good nose for the ball. He gets himself in the good positions. He's got good sort of natural strength. He's not a gym strength person, but he's got good natural strength and he's flipping tough.
Thank you.
Thanks. Julian Guyer, please.
Oh, Eddie. You've given Will Stewart a full debut. You've spoken before about not wanting to pitch people in against the equivalent of Michael Holding at Perth. Isn't putting in a front row forward against Georgia almost that?
Well, we believe he's ready for it. You know, Will started with us at the start of the Six Nations. Again, we need to build depth in that position at three. We've got a great tight head in Kyle Sinclair, but we need to build depth in that position. So we feel he's ready to start the game.
Thank you.
Duncan, we'll come to you, please.
Hi, Eddie. You've talked about Jack's ability with turnovers. What are the other strengths of his game that you've seen?
Well, that's the highlight part of his game. Yeah, he's a good defender. He's a attacker that gets his hands on the ball. He's one of the few forwards in English rugby that's good at the pick and go. So he brings that to the game.
Okay, and Ollie Lawrence in midfield, what are you hoping he brings at outside centre?
Well, again, we're looking to build depth in that position. It's not a position we've got great depth without Manu there. So we're looking to build depth. Yeah, he's a powerful young centre, so we want him to bring that ability to dent the line, create momentum, and then for us to be able to play off the back of that.
Thank you.
Have we got any further set questions for the live section?
Hi, Eddie, it's James. Quick one, Morrow moving to six. Is this a future-proofing thing as an option or is it something that you see as a long-term strategy?
Well, more of the fact that, again, we just want more options. At six, if we need to play three jumpers in our forward pack, then Morrow presents an option there at six. So, yeah, this is as good a game as any to test that selection plan. So, again, it's just a matter of creating options for us.
I know you're not bothered about, you know, well, I know the Lions doesn't come under your remit, but looking forward to the South Africa Lions tour, surely Mara at six makes a lot of sense for that tour as well.
I've got no idea, mate. No interest. Sorry.
Hi, Eddie. Morning. Obviously, you've played at other stadiums without any fans in this period, but, you know, this is going to be the first time back at Twickenham. Is that going to be a kind of surreal, slightly strange experience, do you think?
Well, the only thing we'll experience is gratefulness. Yeah, we're so privileged to be able to play in these circumstances now. I was looking at the stats of the coronavirus this morning. I think it's over 50,000 deaths, 500 a day now. New cases are 20,000 plus, and we've still got the ability to play rugby. So, yeah, obviously we'd like to have fans there, but just to be able to play top level rugby is a privilege for us. So we're just excited about playing.